शुक्लैभ्यामास्मगमपार्थ नैतत्त्वयुपपद्यते क्षुद्रं हृदयदौर्बल्यं त्यक्त्वोत्तिष्ठ परन्तप।
ओ पार्थ, सन ऑफ पृथा, do not give in to this frailty, this weakness. It does not become you. Drop this kshudram hridaya daurbalyam, petty faint-heartedness, and stand up. Uttishtha, O Parantapa, vanquisher of foes. This is an extremely provocative verse. Klaibhyam is literally means eunuch. You're neither a man or a woman, Arjuna. And who is he saying this to? The commander-in-chief. He's telling a fighter, a warrior, a kshatriya. If you're a man, get up and fight. If you're a woman, go home and cook. But don't sit there hanging in between, is what he's saying. So what he means is, the world is provocative. It always provokes you. It always challenges you. And the interesting thing is, when there is a challenge, the best in you comes out. Either you succumb and die, or you get up and fight. These are the only two options we have. Fight doesn't mean please don't end up fighting with people. It's not people that we need to fight. We need to fight challenges. Where are the challenges? Not outside, within. This conflict between our own positive tendencies, our own negative qualities. This conflict between our sattvic qualities, which are fuel, and rajasic and tamasic, which pull us down. And somehow we need to emerge victorious. And that's what he's saying. Parantapa, scorcher of foes, this is your status. Only a human being can fight challenges. No animal can do that. And you're not living up to your dignity. O Partha, son of Pritha, son of Kunti. Kunti, your mother was the one who sent a message to you, through me, says Krishna, to tell you to fight. Fight this battle. Fight for righteousness. Win. So, lady, your mother has said this, and you're sitting there and crying. So, uttishtha, arise. Both physically, get up. You know, when you just sit up like this, your intellect is alert, everything is alive. But when you sit there dejected like that, you don't even feel like thinking. So first thing is, arise, he says, uttishtha, both physically and internally, emotionally. Set aside this faint-heartedness, this petty-mindedness. You know, in India, we have such wonderful qualities, we have such great strengths, but we are petty-minded. We look at little things and fight over little things. You have to put in that effort to rise above that. Everyone must fight and emerge victorious. The outstanding thing about our dharma is this combination. Dharma cannot be upheld out of weakness. It is shakti and abhi, two words that bring across our dharma. Shakti is strength, internal strength, which makes you fearless. If you take the path of non-violence when you are weak, you have no other option. It's like a weak person. If we were weak for 200 years, then we had no strength to fight the British. But when we develop that strength, what kind of strength? Not military strength, not economic power, not political support, but the power of the spirit. We were able to emerge victorious without a single bullet being shot. And that is the power that resides in each one of us. That's all you have to invoke, that power within you, and see what a difference it makes. And when to do it? Not when you're 80 years old. Right now, here and now. If you go home this evening with the determination that I will be strong and I will be fearless. And how to become strong and fearless? Through unselfishness, selflessness, and upholding truth. Whatever you see as truth, uphold it. If you know what is the truth and you don't have the courage to fight for it, what's the use? Stand up is the question. Next verse.